If you're building your own no-code web app or maybe some sort of portal and you need calendar functionality, look no further than this video. We're going to be going into detail about the newest block from Softr, the calendar block. And I'm going to be talking about everything from the things I like about it to the things I hope improve. And I'm going to tell you a couple of pitfalls that I found along the way. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, where I help you organize and automate your life, saving you up to 20 hours every week with no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how I do that, you definitely want to start leveraging the power of automation, and I welcome you to join me in my free webinar. You can get access at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And once you sign up for that, you're going to learn the fundamental building blocks of automation in no code. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We are talking about the calendar block inside of Softr. Now, first and foremost, before we build anything on our front end, we always have to first make sure that we have a strong back-end database. Our data structure, the architecture of our database has to be on point. So first and foremost, I have two simple tables. I have clients. Clients is pretty straightforward. I just have a first name and a last name and an email address. Of course, using that first and last name, I can also then bring in the full name. And then I've got a linked relationship to appointments. Appointments is where all the magic is going to happen. So there's a few fields that you will probably want to have in your calendar setup in order to build this front end for your own Softr app. So first and foremost, you're going to need a start date of your appointment. And in many cases, if you have a certain amount of days that appointments last, well, then you're probably going to want an end date as well. Imagine if you're doing a calendar of conferences or some other sort of events, you're going to have a start and an end date for all the different pieces. Also, in this case, I built an outcome field, and I'll tell you what my thinking was on this, but it turns out I didn't actually need it for my portal. My thinking was that I was going to derive color from this outcome. This is one of those pitfalls I mentioned, so stay tuned for what happened there. Now, the other part I need is color. I need to tell Softr what color I want these records to be when they show up inside of my calendar in Softr. So that's it. Start date, end date, and some sort of color function. Now, the other thing you're going to want is a name for your appointments. Now, of course, in most cases, you're going to already have a solid primary key. That is the leftmost field in your appointment or your calendar table inside of Airtable. So in this case, I'm just concatenating or combining the name of the individual, the name of the client. I'm bringing in the date of the appointment. This is the start date. And I'm also bringing in the outcome of that. So is it rescheduled? Is it a completed appointment or what have you? So using these four elements, we're going to hop into Softr now and get this information mapped up nicely on our block. So first and foremost, if you've never installed a block inside of Softr, simply click the plus wherever you want to add it to your web page. And then over here on the right-hand side, you'll choose dynamic because, of course, this is using dynamic data that is stored in Airtable. Scrolling on down, you will see the calendar block and you only have the one option. Simply install here, and then you're going to need to make sure that it's connected to your Airtable setup. Of course, I've already done this and I've demonstrated how to do this on numerous videos. So if you're curious, you can check my previous videos for those step-by-step instructions. Assuming that you now have your Airtable talking to your Softr, now it's time to set up that particular block. And here is what you're going to see inside. This is where we choose what base we're selected. So this is my base in Airtable is called Scheduler. Then, of course, we have to drill into the table. Mine is called Appointments. And if you have a specific view that you want to focus on, maybe you want to filter in some information, filter out some information, you can do it here. But my favorite place to use filters is actually the inline filters. That's going to come to play in here where I'm using this little section of the block right here. I'm allowing the users with just a simple click to filter in or out all of the calendar appointments that meet certain outcome criteria. So they can now select from that single select and filter the information that's showing up in their particular app or block. Scrolling on down, we now have the search bar functionality. This is where we can allow people to search through the different appointments in our calendar. As you can see here, I'm allowing people to search by the appointment ID, which was my primary field. So if they know the name of the client, or if they know the date, or if they know the outcome, they could use any of those pieces of information to type into the search bar and whittle down what's showing up on the calendar. But now for the good stuff. We're setting up the actual calendar itself. Of course, you have the option to give it a title. I've called mine Appointment Calendar, and that's going to show up right here. I also have a subtitle. I said, look at my amazing schedule, and that's going to show up here. And then, of course, this is where that filter, inline filter, and search bar are going to come into play. Now, beyond that, this is where we have to sync it to those four different fields that I'd mentioned earlier. We have the event title here. This is what we're going to name the event as it shows up in our calendar. This is what I recommended using the primary field for. If you remember, I concatenated a bunch of information in that particular field. Next, what's our start date? And also, what's the end date? And then lastly, what do we want to use to color these records on the calendar? Now, here is the biggest pitfall that I didn't see coming. I assumed that on the event color, and this is actually why I built the outcome single select field for this demonstration, I assumed that I could map the color of these elements to the actual color of this outcome single select field. This is often how Airtable works. You can say, I want to adopt the same color scheme that is demonstrated right here. So my first assumption was, when I was determining the color of the event, that I could reference the outcome field and that it would absorb the color of the particular single select field. So if I were to demonstrate that for you, let me remove the color and instead go to the outcome, you'll see that in fact, they don't take on any color that makes sense to us whatsoever. And this is because the color field that you're mapping to here has to be an actual either color or hex code. You can use a 6-digit hex code. So that is what you're going to see over here in my color field. I have two different hex codes. Let's look at the different options. I built 0067AC, which is actually the Gap Consulting blue color. And I also brought in 6F, which is the white color. Or I also used just standard text for red or green. This works as well. So you'll see that those records now are actually going to show up when I map it properly to the color field. That's where I'm getting the white, the blue, the green, and the red. But let's say this green was too dark for us. It's no problem for us to open up a hex code finder. We can select the exact shade of green that we want, snake that hex code, just copy it to our clipboard, head on back to Airtable, and I'm going to replace it here in my green field. I'm going to go ahead and save that up. I'm going to go back into Softr, and when I go and now refresh my page, we are going to see that it's going to pull in the new upgraded green, and so that's much lighter and easier to read. So there we go. We've got our nice green showing up, and everything is working out pretty well there. So that was an unforeseen hiccup for me, or hurdle. I expected it to map color to the single select field color itself, but in fact, we need to put the text of the color that we want it to be in order to have the right color show up on the calendar. Now, one thing that I don't love about the calendar block just yet is that it does not take time into consideration. Unfortunately, it's only working with dates right now. So even though, let's go back to Airtable, in my case, I've used time in this field as well, date and time. Well, if I drill into my block and now preview it, let's go ahead and open that up. This is what it's going to look like. You'll see that when I click into here, it doesn't bring in the actual time information. And we can see that even a step further. If we drill into the different toggles that we have, we can look at the month or the week. And you see when I drill down to the week, nothing's actually showing up on the calendar itself. Nothing is showing up in time, that is. It is here up at the top, but it's looking as an all-day event as opposed to belonging to a specific time. So I find this somewhat limiting. I'm sure that Softr is going to make massive improvements to this as they have with all of the elements of their software. So over time, I expect this will improve. But right now, the calendar block is only good if you're using date information without time as well. Now, one other thing to take into consideration here is the end date. So if I go back to the setup of this, clicking back in here again, on my end date, I haven't assigned yet an end date. So if I want my dates to span from start to end, I need to actually set that up. And once I've done that, you're going to see that they all lapse over multiple days. Now, in this case, let's go ahead and preview this. You're also going to notice that since I have a lot of information, it's actually too much to see all on one particular date. Well, then I can click into the 3 more, the 8 more, and this is going to give me a breakdown of all the events that are lapsing over this day. So again, there's some room for improvement here in terms of how time comes in, but what I really love is the ability to color code all of these elements. And so I found that to be actually really surprising that they'd included the hex code, and I find it to be quite liberating actually in the way that you can customize how these things are going to be showing up on that calendar. So, what uses do you have for the calendar inside of Softr? I'm anxious to hear. Let me know below what your thoughts are on this, if you agree with my assessment or not. As always, if you're looking to save more time with no code, definitely subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss out on future videos, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.